Hi students, coming to the next topic in the subject mobile computing was GSM. So this is one of the important concept. In this video I want to explain what exactly the GSM was and the architecture of GSM. GSM is a global system for mobile communication. It is a global system for mobile communication. You are having a mobile phone, right? So each and every mobile phone, there is a GSM facility will be there. So this is going to establish a communication. It's a global communication. A global communication will be established for communication. Okay, let me explain the thing. GSM is based on the set of standard formulated in the early 1980s by companies Nokia, Motorola and Ericsson. So many companies are there. So all those companies is formulated this GSM based on the set of standards. What are the goals of this global system for mobile communication? G means global, S is systems, M is mobile communication. Global system mobile communication. The main goals of GSM are, it supports international roaming. Okay, suppose your mobile is having the GSM facility, GSM chip is available for you. You can use your mobile phone in another country also. It supports the international roaming facility. The clear voice clarity. With the help of this global system for mobile communication, that is a GSM service, you are having the voice of communication will be clear. Ability to support multiple handheld devices. Spectral or frequency efficiency will be there. Low powered handheld devices. Ease of accessing the network. International ISDN compatibility. So these are all the goals of GSM. So by seeing these goals, what you understand, the main use of this global system for mobile communication is used for the voice clarity and for international roaming and for international ISDN compatibility and ease of accessing networks. We are using the global system for mobile communication. Now let's see the architecture. The global system mobile communication architecture, that is a network, can be broadly divided into main three. The complete architecture is divided into three subsystems. Okay, so complete, this is the GSM. The GSM consisting of these main concepts. One is the radio or base station subsystem, RSS, radio subsystem, network switching subsystem, and operation support subsystem. The complete GSM is divided into radio subsystem, network switching subsystem, and operation support subsystem. Okay, so radio base station subsystem. So for receiving the signals from the base stations, this RSS will be useful. And the network switching subsystem, if you want to switch the network from one network to another network, the GSM is using the network system switching subsystem. And OSS is dealing with the operational support of the subsystem, means whatever the mobile device that you are using, that complete operational setup will be handled by the operation support subsystem. So the complete GSM is based on these three subsystems. So it requires the radio station subsystem, network switching subsystem, the operation support subsystem. So just remember these three subsystems. Now let's see the architecture. So here, this is an architecture architecture view of GSM. Here the additional components of GSM architecture comprises of databases and messaging system functions. So whatever the terms that I used here, the abbreviations, so those I have written here. HLR means home location register. I already explained what HLR will store. HLR is a database used to store the current location of the mobile. Current location of mobile device. Whereas visitor, VLR means visitor location register. It is also a database. It stores the visitor location of mobile. And equipment ID register. The equipment ID register is also a database. This is used to store the equipment regarding what type of mobile you are having and what IP your mobile is having. Means, suppose if your mobile is missed or it was theft by someone, by using this equipment identity register, you can find out where your mobile was. So that is also EIR is also a database which stores the information regarding your mobile. And authentication center, okay, this authentication center is monitoring your mobile with so whatever the calls that you are getting is safety and secure, like that, authentication center. And SMS SE, that is a SMS servicing center. GMSC means gateway mobile switching center. So you already know that mobile switching center, so all mobile switching centers will be connected to one gateway, will be there in between the mobile switching center and the external public switch telephone network. There is a gateway connection will be there. So that I already explained how the database user, the user device mobile will be connected to the public switch telephone network with the help of the middleware, and with the help of this gateway you are communicating, with the help of the network you are communicating the voice or data, whatever it may be, okay. And chargeback centers, transcoder and adaption unit. Now let's see the architecture. So what I said, the complete GSM architecture is divided into three subsystems: radio subsystem, okay, radio station subsystem, network switching subsystem and operational switching subsystem. So this is a complete structure. So what this radio station subsystem consisting of? So up to here, this is a radio station subsystem. This is a coverage area. So in each, a cell will be there. So what I said, the cell consisting of base station, that is a transmitter which transmits and receives the signal. So there is cells will be there, that is the radio cells will be there. So each radio cells is having the base stations, okay, the mobile stations will be there, okay. And BSS, so what I said, the BSS is the base station, base switching center, base switching center and base switching circuit controller. You said can base station controller. This is BSC is a base station controller. So just remember that the radio cells consisting of the different cells, each radio cells is having their own base station. BTS means base station. There is having the base station. A base station will be connected to the mobile services. So there are, this base station is connected to two mobile services and this base station is connected to one mobile services. Let us take, so many mobile services will be connected. Each base station is handling one mobile services. So in between the mobile services and the base station, there is an interface will be there. UM interface will be there. Remember that. RSS is going to connect, it is a base station. Each base station connects one or more mobile services. A interface is established between the base station and the mobile system services, mobile systems. So the base station controller is having one or more base stations. BTS or BS, both are the same, okay, don't confused. So what I said, one base station controller is handling multiple base stations. So it is going to be decided which base station will be suit for which call, that is controlled by base station controller. So there is an interface between the base station and the base station controller, that is ABIS. One interface will be there, okay. And different base controllers will be there, base station controllers will be there. So one base station control is monitoring some cells and another base station controller is monitoring another cells, like that. So this complete structure, you call it as a system, you call it as a radio switching subsystem. Okay, so what it is, radio station subsystem. RSS is a radio station subsystem. Is it clear? This radio station subsystem consisting of the radio cells, that radio cells is monitor having different base stations. The base station is handling one or more mobile services. All these base stations are controlled by one base station controller. Okay. So now let's coming to the next subsystem. So here everything, the connection is established. So this connection is, the base stations is controlled by the base station switching circuit. Okay, so this will be controlled by mobile switching circuit. The mobile switching circuit is present in the network subsystem, network switching subsystem. Okay, so this mobile switching circuit or mobile switching controller is handling the VLR, visitor location register, EIR, identity register, HLR, okay, and all OM authentication, GHMC, gateway, IWF. So these are all the terms I will explain clearly, don't be confused. And OSS, the operating switching subsystem consisting of the operations like authentications or the identity of the mobile. Okay, all that information will be stored in the operating subsystem. So the complete GSM will be divided into radio switching subsystem, network switching subsystem, and operating switching subsystems. Okay, so this deals with the cells and the base station controller. And here it is completely about the database, means the details of the means the locations of the mobile phone, monitored by the mobile switching circuit, and OSS is having the identity and authentication, that you have to be remember. Now let's see what exactly the each terms will be. Before going that, I want to just show you this diagram. So here one base station is there, BS, and another base station in this cell, one base station, and this base station is controlled by base station control unit. Okay, and this base station is controlled by another base station control unit. So many base stations are and this cell base station is also controlled by base station control unit. Did you observe here? This cell is controlled by one control unit, and this cell transceiver is controlled by this base station control unit. Okay, all these base station control unit are connected to mobile switching center. Mobile switching center. So this mobile switching center is having a gateway mobile switching center. A mobile switching center is having the gateway mobile switching center, and with the help of the gateway, it sends connected to the public switch telephone network or PDN or ESDN like this. And here this mobile switching center is having the information like EIR, the mobile entity identity register, authentication of the mobile, and home location register of mobile, and visitor location register of the mobile. Did you observe that? So the mobile systems will be there. So each mobile system is connected to one base station. Each mobile system is connected to one base system. So base station. So each base station, one or more base stations are connected to the base station controller unit. So these base station controller unit are connected to mobile switching center. So this mobile switching center is having the information regarding your mobile, and it sends the message through gateway to the public switch telephone network. So this is how the GSM will be established. The connection will be established from one station to MSC and there to PSTN. Now let's see this architecture clearly. What are the subsystems? I said, let me show you this diagram and explain it. So here in the subsystem, what I said, the radio subsystem consisting of what it consisting of? It consisting of mobile system and the base station. Base station switching circuit. Okay, system. And BSS with BTS and BSC, that is a base station and the base station control unit. And what about the network subsystem? The network subsystem consisting of MSC, the mobile switching circuit, VLR, HLR, and VLR, and GHMC. So these are all connected to the network subsystem. And what about the operation subsystem? The operation subsystem consisting of EIR and AU, authenticator. So here I'm just giving the overview, what components that are present in the radio subsystem and what components that are present in the network subsystem and what components that are present in the operation subsystem. Now let's see the first one, radio subsystem functions. What are the functions of this radio subsystem? The radio subsystem, first it consisting of a BSS, I say, base subsystem. Why we use a base subsystem? It maintains the radio connections to mobile system. It maintains the radio connections to mobile system and it performs the coding or decoding of the voice and rate adaption. So these are the functions that base subsystem will provide. Then why we are using this BTS? BTS is nothing but the base transceiver station, or we can call simply base station. What the use of this base station? It comprises of antennas, signal processing, amplifiers, etc. It can form a signal or several radio cells by using the sectorized antenna. So with the help of the different antennas, it can receive the signals and transmits the signals. Next, what term that this RS is consisting of? BSC. What is this BSC? BSC is the base station controller. Base station controller. The name itself is saying it is going to control what devices? It manages radio resources for one or more base stations. It is going to manage one or more base stations, handles radio setup, frequency hopping, and handles inter-cell handovers. Then what about the mobile stations? What is the use of these mobile stations? This mobile stations, MEI, is used to identify the mobile station, consist of a mobile equipment and SIM. That mobile station is consisting of the mobile equipment and the SIM card, whatever the SIM card that you are using. It is basically the mobile handset. Simply you call it as a mobile handset. And in between them, there is a UM interface will be there. The UM interface is the air interface of the radio waves. So that is about this radio subsystem. Now let's come into the network subsystem, this part. What are the functions of this network subsystem? It connects the radio networks, so it is going to connect, this is completely radio network. So this network subsystem connects this radio network with standard public network. It contains the databases like HLR and VLR and switches for GSM. The mobiles, first is the mobile service switching center. The mobile service switching center, MSC, is established in the network and switching subsystem. So what's the function of this MSC? Their high performance digital ISDN switches will be there. Each mobile switching center controls one or more BSS. See here, it controls one or more BSS. This is one BS and it is going to control another BSS. The mobile switching center can perform registration, authentication, location updating, network interfacing. So these are the functions that this mobile switching center can perform. It performs a registration, authentication, location updating, network interfacing. And what is the next term? GMSC. That is a gateway mobile switching center. It is responsible for communication with external fixed networks such as public switch telephone network and ISDN. And the next term that we are having is the IWF. So this is completely, it is in this NSS only. Internet working function. This internet working function is attached to the GM, Gateway Mobile Switching Center. Internet working function. It provides the mobile switching center to convert to public data network. Okay, so whatever the mobile switching circuit will send that information, that it contains the convert the data into public data network. Next is the home location register. The home location register is a central database holds the permanent details about the subscriber. Suppose you are the subscriber and you are Airtel subscriber like that. So your complete permanent details will be stored in home location register. So it has a static and the dynamic information is also there. Static information regarding your mobile data and your address, permanent address, everything will be static. And the dynamic information is nothing but the location. You are shifting, suppose you are at present it in Hyderabad, suppose you are going to somewhere else, Vijayawada. The location is changing. So this home location register may be a static and the dynamic. And in the network switching subsystem, VLR is there. So visitor location register. It is also a database. HLR is a central database and this is a database, VLR, containing records of all mobile stations currently registered with the MSC. So visitor location register, when you are moving from one place to another place, it stores the information regarding all the mobile stations currently registered with the mobile switching center. Okay, and finally the last subsystem is the operational subsystem. So the operational subsystem, what is the use of this operational subsystem? A functional entity used to monitor and control the overall GSM network. It is going to monitor and control the overall GSM network. So the radio system sending the radio signals. And the next is the network. Network is maintaining and controlling databases and the signals. And whereas the operational subsystem is monitor and control overall GSM network. Overall GSM network. So these are the three subsystems. User to control the traffic load. And this operational subsystem contains OMC, operation and maintenance center, authentication center, equipment identity register. So it consisting of EIR. So, equipment identity register regarding your mobile, OMC is operation maintenance center and authentication control center. Authentication center. So, this is about the GSM architecture. So, whenever you asked about what is a GSM architecture, try to explain about the three subsystems and take any general example and explain it in live. Okay. Thank you.